الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. In our social interactions, greeting may be widely prevalent, but usage of the actual words is often undermined. The significance of the words of salam is learnt from a famous hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wherein Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reported to have said that when Allah Ta'ala created Adam alayhi salam, Adam alayhi salam was instructed by Allah to greet a group of malaika. It was said to Adam alayhi salam, "Idhhab fasallim ala ulaik." Go and greet the group of malaika. "Fastami' ma yuhayyunak." Listen very carefully to their response. "Fa'innaha tahiyyatuk wa tahiyyatu thurriyatik." Their response will be your greeting and the greeting of your progeny. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, in compliance with that command, approached the malaika and greeted them with the words, "Assalamu alaykum." فقالوا, they responded, "Assalamu alayka wa rahmatullah." May peace be upon you, wa rahmatullah, and the mercy of Allah be upon you. فزادوه rahmatullah. The malaika added the words rahmatullah to the words of salam. So in this one hadith, we learn that the words of salam are indeed significant and enjoy great virtue based on the premise that they were taught to Adam alayhi salam by the malaika. Realizing this virtue of salam, some of the companions of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam seized opportunities to make salam using these words. It is said regarding Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu an, that he would go into a marketplace and simply return home without enacting a single transaction. On one occasion, he was accompanied by Tufail, the son of Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhuma, and the same thing happened, same thing transpired. He returned home without enacting a transaction. So Tufail ibn Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhuma asked him the reason for going into the marketplace and returning without a transaction. So Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu explained to Tufail ibn Ubay ibn Ka'b that he said, "Ya Aba Batn," he addressed him as Aba Batn, the father of the stomach, because Tufail's stomach was slightly protruding. "Innama naghdu min ajli salam." We only leave home for the sake of greeting people. "Nusallim ala man laqinahu." We use the words of salam on whoever we meet. So we learn that the words of salam is probably one of the best supplications that can be made upon or for anyone that is being greeted. This particular hadith of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu an, it does not necessarily mean that we should frequent the marketplaces for such reasons. The marketplaces of our time are very different to the marketplaces of the companions of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Be that as it may, against this backdrop in which we realize the significance of the words of salam as words taught to Adam alayhi salam by the malaika, the first etiquette is to refrain from foreign forms of greeting. Forms of greeting which are not consistent with the teachings of Islam. They may not necessarily be un-Islamic, but they are foreign in terms of the teachings of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and are often forms of greeting which are taken from societies which are not friendly to Islam, and thus particularly the youth should refrain from using foreign forms of greeting one another. The second etiquette is to try our level best to utter the words of salam more so when greeting from a distance. Inevitably, when greeting from a distance, the greeting takes place through a gesture of the hand or a slight nodding of the head, but we should never lose sight of the significance of the words of salam. So together with the gesture of the hand or the head, there should be the utterance of the words of salam. And the third and final etiquette is to refrain from greeting when a person is engaged in some work or even a conversation or even eating. We should not become the hindrance to someone losing their chain of thought while they are engaged in conversation, given that they realize that it's important to reply to salam. As a result of that reply to a salam, they may lose the chain of thought and be inconvenienced in some way. So the question may cross the mind that what if I walk past someone and they take offense for not greeting them? The response is, if there is sufficient amount of education regarding the words of salam and the context of salam, then we will all realize that if someone has to walk past without greeting, It is possible that they have not created as a result of being in conversation maybe or engaged in something that was preoccupying at the time. May Allah Ta'ala grant us all the ability to adhere to and adopt or even disseminate and share with others these basic etiquettes of salam itself. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.